Good morning. I have often wondered, how do we forgive the unforgivable, either a person or a happening? How can we learn to see ourselves and others, put ourselves in their place, see life through their eyes, and find compassion for even the worst that they do to us? Has the pandemic brought us closer to our real nature, which is to love? Or has it made us so fearful that all that we witness is done so from the lens of a disheartened, angry person? At the peak of the COVID scare last year, people had got to the place where their survival depended on all the information they could get from as many sources as possible, like a constant drip through the day and night. The news was always the same, grave and fearsome. The outcome always the same. Wanting to share it with the largest possible audience. And people that use social media with a conscience do so to engender support for causes that will save the lives of people. And then you have people using social media mindlessly, causing fear and confusion. So with so much of negative information, much of the time it proved to be unconstructive and unhelpful to most people. Now, until it was realized that it actually didn't take much effort, only awareness, to remain neutral and avoid adding our own partially thought out theories to the depressing news already being thrown around. Now, the negative bias of our brain is really compelling and persuasive, and it feeds into our threat of survival. Together, all the evidence gathered against something by millions of clueless people then only causes mass hysteria. And when mass consciousness of despair reaches a certain level, it's difficult to break up such conversations easily and interject positivity. The point is, we must prevent such a thing from happening in the first place. And the responsibility lies with each individual to uplift and inspire, not deflate the confidence of people that are not strong enough by themselves. You are familiar with the reptilian brain. We've talked about it many times, of course. For those who don't know, it lives a pretty secure life here at the base of your skull, making sure that your survival always has top priority. Little does it know to differentiate between a real tiger and an assumed one, an imaginary one. However, it cannot discern between real and fake news, and when we are anxious about our survival, we can't access our analytical reasoning brain, which is here. So with so much at stake and so much that causes us harm in any way, the ideal way is to control our urges to share negativity. And the good news is we can build a new memory bank of positive thoughts with positive emotions and behavior as the outcome. Neuroscience suggests that a ratio of 3:1 for positive thoughts to countermand the huge backlog of memory that we have in relation to negative things that have happened to us. Living in survival mode is rather adverse, you will agree, when it concerns our own well-being. Because when we find it hard to forgive ourselves for the things we do and the things we say when we react from fear of threat, while we are as yet nowhere close to eradicating the virus, people's losses are fearsomely mounting, and then naturally reacting from a survival mode seems fated and impossible to exit. If we find it hard to explain to ourselves and understand and accept our own fate, we will find it impossible to forgive the others, even partly responsible for the state we are in. So here are a few options to try out to reach some place of forbearance and acceptance. Let us normalize our extraordinary experience first by taking the me out of it. Empathizing with others that have had similar losses makes us want to reach out to them. It softens our stand and is one step towards erasing files in our own negative memory system. We are using forgiveness to change our perception of what is happening and what happened in the past. So by understanding why we do what we do, that we have neural wiring in the brain that drives us to think negative thoughts, have self-defeating beliefs, self-sabotaging behaviors, we feel compassion for ourselves. We all do similar things at different times. And so because I behave at times in exactly the same way as those I condemn, they too suffer from my negative bias. So if I can learn to be kinder to myself, I can extend that grace to others too. It's very straightforward. Observation and acceptance is another thing that we can do. As we age, it is natural to wake up in the morning and notice the first thing that we notice is sore back muscle or an impinged nerve in the shoulder area. A missed alarm sets us back by 15 minutes and we're super tense about how we will fit in all that we had planned for the day. To make matters worse, we notice the smog outside, obscuring the morning blue sky we love so much. And we start thinking about environmental degradation, which makes us even more grumpy. Before we know it, we are headed into escalating negative observations and thoughts. If we are to believe the 3:1 ratio, then we need to internalize 9 positives in our environment to cancel the effects from these negatives. And it's just the morning yet. But what happens is by then, we are in the throes of a flight or fight reptilian response to stress. And discerning how beautiful life is practically non-doable by the neocortex in that very moment. However, we have a solution. If we had an ongoing practice of gratitude, of forgiveness, or abundance, something that we have been doing for a while, we can observe the occurrence of phenomena in our life and yet learn to stay equanimous. The third thing that we can do is soak in the positive. We may not like others to know this, but we know on which side we are. Whether our energy signature vibrates at a negative or a positive note. Thus, you would also know that merely having a positive experience isn't the end of it. Savoring it and stoking its fires for longer than 20 to 30 seconds will give you its true lasting benefit. It takes that long for an observation or thought to travel into the subconscious where our implicit memory lies. And here, repeated thoughts will work towards building newer, more empowering pathways. The brain, with the help of this cumulative memory of many, many such positive experiences over time, will start predicting similar future occurrences. And in time, we start putting out consistent positive behavior to attract positive outcomes. Old neural pathways of flight or fight responses are then replaced with new ones. Consider then your brain is rewired. One of the involuntary outcomes of the pandemic has been a blurring of separator values and a merging together of people across all levels. It could not have happened without humans overriding negative bias and choosing to be kind over being right. Another thing that is an option for us is something called titration. In the realm of positive experiences, we raise our vibrations, don't we? If you are a newbie to this thought process, in the initial stages of any newly learned behavior, you may easily regress into negative thoughts or negative intention, and it also happens with people who've been doing this for a long time. Because our memory is so wide, so large in the subconscious, that we keep working with layers and layers of it, and yet there is so much more. During the pandemic, altruistic inclinations were widely expressed across the globe and definitely in a country like mine, where the disparities are so large. But it doesn't mean we have to hold up a moral barometer to measure how often we are generous and how many times we put ourselves ahead of others. It isn't a contest. It is natural progression from me to V orientation and mustn't be forced upon anyone to conform to any standard. As the physical distance automatically between two negatives starts to increase, it starts creating space for more positives because the space will always get filled. You become more attuned to positives and eventually you will easily titrate between the two at will. Instead of being forced to be in a certain way because your brain functions in a certain way. Choosing between positive and negative in your consciousness teaches your brain how to align with the positive network of neurons that now fire together, creating more solid pathways of cooperation and caregiving. Well, this is quite a bit of information to chew on. Hopefully there's something in it for each of you. Be seeing you tomorrow. Stay safe, stay indoors. Bye for now.
Help Talks are daily health-related talks held at Health Education Library for People, Mumbai, India. For more information, visit www.healthlibrary.com. Subscribe to Help Talks channel. Be better informed about your health.